and welcome to the Penguin Prof channel. I'm Valerie Pennington. I've got a quick bite for you today. We're going to talk all about GIFs, why you should consider them, how to make them, and how to get them into your Canvas pages. A GIF is an image file, but what's kind of magical about them is you can use them to make animated images, usually 15 to 20 frames per second. So as you can see here, they're usually a little bit jagged looking. This is kind of old school internet, but they're making a comeback. They're really great to add visual interest and to show very short procedures. So what I want to do is show you two Canvas pages and you see for yourself which one you like better. So here I am in Canvas, and we're going to look at two pages with the same content. We're going to introduce the Gen 2 penguin here, and this is a very nice image. You see the three penguins. It's a little unclear what's going on. There's nothing wrong with this page. What about this instead? This is an embedded GIF in my Canvas page, and I think we can all agree that watching the Gen 2 penguins on the left trying to have sex, the one on the right is just kind of lost. This is a lot more engaging, so I'm going to show you how to make a GIF and how to get it into your Canvas page. So there are websites that you can use to make GIFs where you basically can upload either video files or image files and it will generate GIFs for you. These are the three most popular ones. Links will be in the description box. You can also use software like Snagit, and that's what I'm going to show you right now. So I'm launching Snagit. I'm going to make a video capture here, and I'm going to select a region. So when I click capture, I get these crosshairs, and I'm selecting the region that I want the recording to take place. And when I click record, I'm going to get a countdown. If you don't like that, you can change it in settings. But GIFs are really great for demonstrating short procedures. So here I am just demonstrating different heading options in Canvas, so I could show you something that had a few steps in it. And that's it. When I'm done, I click stop, and now the file opens in Snagit, and here it starts to play immediately. And what you can do on the timeline down here, the green is the endpoint where I want the video to begin, and the red is the out point where I want it to end. When you click GIF, you can either use the whole video or just the selection, which is what I want. I'm going to select screen video. You want to use high motion if you're importing like video from a camera. Use that fade to black and click create. And it creates the GIF, and now it will start to play and it will loop and you'll see what it looks like. You have the original and the new GIF that you've just made in the tray. And I check and make sure that it looks good, and the black helps the viewers to know that the loop is ending. Go ahead and save the file and you're good to go. Here I am in Canvas. When you want to embed the GIF, remember it's an image, so select Embed Image. And I'm going to upload the file that I just created. There's my GIF. And don't forget to change the alt text to describe what the GIF is showing. And go ahead and click update. And now the GIF appears in your Canvas page. And as soon as the page launches, it will start to play and it will loop and it will show the procedure or the penguins having sex or whatever you want. And it's just that easy. As always, I hope that was helpful. Thank you so much for visiting the Penguin Prof channel. For more videos like this, check out the EdTech playlist, and I'll see you in the next video. Good luck.